Whatever.
Close enough. It's fine.
You fucked up. Look at this pool of jam. Look at this pool of...
It's mostly not mine, I think.
Is the jam blood
orange? Yeah, you should
see
the other guy.
That is the other guy.
In fact, yes, that is the other guy. Oh, the other girl, we should say.
Should be after last weekend.
Yeah, basically. Look, all I'm saying is I have another badge of honor to wear, and that's I walked up to a Detroit cop while hammered on a Sunday night and said, "You know what? I would love to fuck the police," and he just laughed it off. So I didn't get murdered in Detroit for that, so I'll take it. Anyway, welcome to Dark Souls.
Hey, we're going to the dreg heap.
It's also me last weekend.
That's basically
so this is
going to
be an accurate representation of Shibo's weekend.
Okay, but so the dreg heap. What is this DLC called, Iggy?
It's called the Ringed City.
It's the O-Ringed City.
Oh, okay. I take it there's going to be actual plot coming up eventually?
Yeah, the stuff that we mostly skip, yeah,
okay,
exactly.
Good. Yeah, good stuff.
Yeah, alright, so here's the rundown, Shibby. Do you remember the horrendously twisted city that we saw from the bonfire before the final boss?
Yes.
We are in that city.
Okay, and this is the second DLC, the one that just came out not too long ago?
That's right.
Yeah, it came out, well, I think 2 weeks ago. This is like a day one Let's Play.
Yeah, so this is some kind of fucked up,
Oh.
Yeah, don't worry.
Oh good, no fall damage.
It's perfectly fine. Yeah, so I mean, this is kind of like some sort of horrendous post-apocalyptic future where everything got all twisted up.
Rocking.
Yeah, there's angels. Look at that.
What? Okay. Are angels canon to the Dark Souls universe? I mean, I guess they are now. Yeah, but...
I mean, they've been mentioned previously, but this is the first time we see them. Or so we think, because we actually saw them before, only they didn't have cute angel wings. They looked more like trees back then.
Yeah. You remember that, that big sort of, like... circulatory system angel Slayer boss fight? Yeah.
Yeah. The ones that I thought were set pieces and then realized, no wait, they're actual things.
They're like, no, it's shooting at us.
Alright, cool.
They nerfed these angels to hell, by the way. They used to be really dangerous.
They used to be like pinpoint accurate.
Yeah, and people whined about them really hard, and now they... I know you can just walk past them, pretty much. I mean, you're supposed to walk past them, but it's much easier now.
Look at all the fucked up roots on these guys, that's crazy.
Yeah. I mean, in this, like, however many years since the last time we've seen them, I guess. Look, geometry's falling.
I mean, that's always a good sign.
Wow, this is so suitably epic. It really feels like... Oh,
That was kind of creepy.
That was the actual angel, by the way.
I'm gonna astral project my nervous system into the air.
Yeah, that's right. Nobody must know that on the internet I'm actually just like a snapdragon-shaped peener.
Yeah. I have just been a brain the whole time. Also, sick dodge there, Iggs. Good stuff.
I tried.
He wanted to really, really make sure that he got hit by that.
Yeah, I wanted to sell that guy's move, yeah.
I do like the little, crawling sickle zombies. Iggs. Oh, what? How is that okay? Wait a minute.
There's that sigil thing that breaks my fall. It's so good.
Oh, the magical hay bale. Got it.
This is now pilot wings.
I don't even have to land inside it. I can land like way, way, way far away from it, and it'll still count.
But if you do, you won't get your gold rank certification, and be able to go on to the choplifter sequence.
And I mean, you know, if you're not going for the gold, what's even the point of trying?
Your flight instructors are gonna look at you all sad. Oh, stop nuking the little creepies, man!
Alright, friendly fire.
This angel is indiscriminate.
Anything that moves. It's a motion-activated sentry.
So what do you think of the noise that angel makes? Is it sufficiently, beautiful and ethereal? It sure fills me with a sense of the glory of God.
Yeah, same.
I don't know. I feel like it could be a little more seraphic.
What kind of noise do you think that they should make?
I'm not gonna answer that for the sake of Iggy's LP. Because,
oh man.
Because the incredibly cheap joke was yip yip, but
Nice.
Oh, I'm not gonna say it, but I'm totally gonna say it. Good.
Yeah, exactly.
That's what they call the old bait and switch.
Yeah, well, I've made
masterful
a couple things.
The bait and switch.
Yeah. Isn't that the new Nintendo console? The bait and switch?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not bad.
I try.
Today's a day of trying, it seems.
I'm so upset by everything. I'm gonna shoot lasers.
Well, see, that's what I kind of mean though. It's not like it's not glorious. It's not powerful. It's more just like a slightly irritated meow. You know, I would expect
it's
like
the sound I make when I chop off a fingertip with a chisel.
Have you done that?
I like that this guy's nothing but a giant butthole. Like, look at him. His whole front bit is a butthole, and then his face is a shadowy butthole.
The Headless Horseman's lesser known pal, the Headless Butthole.
The Buttless Horseman.
But how does he ride? Ooh!
His beehole is actually just a pumpkin. Yo! Sorry for the pumpkin joke, homie. You didn't have to go so extreme.
I mean, he kind of did, let's be real. Let's see.
My butt is not a pumpkin!
To be fair, if you called my butt a pumpkin, I would probably also be very irritated.
Yeah, man. I bet you'd go,
That's the greatest expression of primal rage that has ever existed.
Just a big old guy with big old muscles just being like,
The M. Bison battle cry.
I'm a bit sad I don't do face cam because you really need to see my face to appreciate my reactions to this conversation.
I'm glad you don't do face cam because I'd probably vomit all over my laptop. Oh, I'm sorry. That was mean. I love you, buddy.
That's not just mean.
It's accurate.
You don't even know how fucking pretty I am.
Yeah. It's just patently untrue. Iggy's handsome as fuck. That's why he does Let's Plays.
Oh, yes, exactly. That's the reason.
Yes.
Ain't even got a face for radio. Seriously, I hate these things, by the way. Those are fucking disgusting.
Yeah, they're definitely a little more fleshy than I would prefer.
Like, I'm pretty sick of getting Cronenberg'd by this game.
Elaborate.
Oh, Cronenberg's a Canadian director who specializes in body horror movies.
Oh,
he directed
God Almighty.
The Jeff Goldblum version of The Fly.
Oh, okay. Yeah, alright.
Yeah.
I mean, I said previously, body horror itself, not that big for me, unless it's like eyes. Eyes and fingernails, for whatever reason, I can't do it.
I find the human body disgusting at the best of times in its most aesthetically pleasing sense, so.
Remind me to send you a selfie later. Iggy, are you having some problems knocking your bow there? Come on, dude.
It's hard.
Much like the human
you
body, it's most attractive. Anyway.
You shoot like a Frenchman. There, I said it.
Oh, God. That's just vicious, man. Come on, that's a low blow.
Well, look, man. You know I'm of English ancestry, so archery skills are pretty near and dear. Actually, I probably couldn't do better. I don't even know which end of the bow the string goes on.
Which
is
end?
Towards you, away from you? Like, do bows have ends? I'm not even. Is that the terminology?
Yeah, it's great. Don't worry about it. You're fucking professional.
Yeah.
You're gonna get certified in no time.
It's perfect.
What is this? Something
yeah.
Devout pyromancer? Something other?
Desert pyromancer?
Desert pyromancer, yes, from Dark Souls 2.
Oh.
Desert pyromancer Zoe.
Yes.
She even
Zoe,
has a name.
The great sorceress to strike fear in the hearts of men. Zoe.
And you shall know my name. It is Zoe.
Like, imagine the creepy-ass fucking angels, and you're just like, what are you? She's like,
Jeremiah.
My name is Steven.
There are some who call me Matt.
Nice, whip it good, man.
Yeah, that's got some real reach.
Close
to
on
it,
you,
huh?
Lady. Come on, buddy.
Choose mine.
PvP duel this little biscuit. Wait, she ain't a red phantom. She's literally here.
Yeah.
That's weird.
Did that kill her?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
No, she'll be running back up at the most inopportune time. Iggy's going to be getting his ass kicked by one of those butthole root monsters, and she's just going to come up and be like, I'm going to whip you in the back of the neck. And Dude. Then Iggy will be like, well, let's just do a quick cut.
Frame perfect splicing.
And that's the last we're gonna hear of them.
Yeah, that's probably for the best. I'm distinctly sick of them.
I mean, the weird nervous angels themselves I quite like, but I kind of have to agree with you on their whole hosts being oddly multi-faced phallic protrusions from the earth.
Yeah,
oh
man.
Yeah, here's another one.
World boners.
Like, and that's just kind of a guy wrapped up in a ding-dong kind of thing. Looks like it's grown out of the back of one of the stone humps in one of the, pilgrims.
Yeah, exactly. That's what they are.
Oh, is that what happens? A pilgrim gets all freaky and shoots an angel out of its back?
When a mommy
Pretty
pilgrim
much, yeah.
and a daddy pilgrim love each other very much. They
I mean, the big nervous, systems, they're called pilgrim butterflies.
Oh, that's terrifying.
Oh.
Ew.
Yeah, actually,
Because that really does give the whole cocoon bursting you. Ooh, ooh. Oh, I'm not comfortable now. Okay.
Pilgrim butterfly sure sounds like some sort of extremely niche section on a certain website.
Good. Thank you. Please elaborate.
Website.
Yeah, a certain website.
What else could Oh, God, this reminds me of last weekend. Like
I'm
a hot
sure
dog down a hallway. Anyway.
Yo! Demon in pain, demon from below.
Yeah, so we killed some angels, now it's the demon's turn.
Oh, cool, it's the Dan Brown special.
Yeah.
So which one is this? The demon from below?
The demon from below is the one that glows orange. The one we're fighting right now.
Alright.
And the other one should be glowing red, and that's demon in pain.
It's not even like demon of pain, it's literally just a demon in pain. My fibromyalgia, no!
Oh, no! Nothing works!
I'm out of a leave, fuck you!
Justin Trudeau, legalize medical marijuana for all the demons in pain.
Please stop sending people in flowing robes with katanas to take care of your problems. Just legalize pot, it'll all be fine.
You gotta legalize it! We should decriminalize demons.
I mean, they tried to poison me and kill me, so...
I mean, like, that's a problem, but I mean, we already demonized criminals, so...
Oh, man.
Oh, God,
trying
real.
To... Trying to kill and poison you, man. That sounds like my last relationship. Hey!
Oh! Oh! Too real.
Welcome to Dark Souls 3.
Sounds vaguely like me last weekend, actually.
Oh, there you go. Oh!
Detroit.
Nice!
Yeah!
Oh, get him.
Get him!
I mean, he can't be in pain anymore if he's dead.
That's right. Oh, look at him. He's all like, I'm in so much pain, I'm gonna expel all of my gloopies.
Aw, rip demon.
Yep, you got time to eat a flowering purple moss clump. Ah, you killed my pain brother. My pain brother is dead, and now I'm double pain.
They're just...
I'll come at you from below.
I'm actually a little sad that these don't have better names. They really are hopelessly generic.
Yeah, they're not really that evocative, all told. kind of throwaway boss fight.
Beware. You
think of a good name for that boss, then.
Just bullshit. You could probably just restructure, like, old archangel or demon names, you know? Belial, Azazel, and, like, Samael. There's plenty of things. Oh, Demon Prince. Really?
This one's called Explodo.
Explodo the Demon Prince.
Like, Explodo is quite good. I'm okay with that. Explodo Baggins will be fine.
Explodo Baggins, Hobbit from Hell. Rated
That's
R.
Right.
I think we just found an episode title.
The first two guys should be called could be called Plinky and Blonky, because right? Like, what's up? We're Plinky and Plonky, the Demon Brothers. I'm Plinky, I'm in pain. Oh, I'm Plonky, I'm from below.
Oh yeah.
By our powers combined, we are Explodo Baggins. Wonder Twin powers activate.
That's right.
I will say, I do actually, despite the names being a sticking point, I really like the design both of the first two and this guy. He looks very badass.
Yeah, it's,
he explodes a lot.
It's weird that, you know, it's gotten so biblical, because throughout the rest of Dark Souls, demons, as they were, are basically just agents of chaos.
Religion is the true darkness.
I mean, they still are, like, born of chaos. Those are literally the last demons in existence. Almost, well, almost, okay. Nothing really goes extinct in Dark Souls for real. There's still dragons roaming about.
Well, yeah, I mean, time is convoluted.
You son of a bitch.
What? No, it literally is convoluted.
Yeah, that's actually, like, one of the lore explanations that the game gives you.
Alright, I will forgive you this once.
But, like, So demons initially, they were born out of the, you know, the chaos flame that the Witch of Izalith tried to create to replace the first flame, and that went all completely wrong.
Oh gee, well, the name, like, Flame of Chaos, I wonder why.
Right?
Or how. Oh man, those tendon wings are really fucking cool, actually, on the forearms.
Yeah. I'd really like to toss them in a little bit of, like, cayenne pepper and hot sauce and butter.
Skippy, what the fuck?
And just maybe serve him up with, you know, with a pitcher of beer. That'd be alright. Old Pappy Granola's demon wings! They ain't nothing but tendon.
Get them while they're hot. They're always hot. They will explode with flavor.
One might say they're damned good.
Sinfully delicious.
Oh, yeah. You will literally go to hell if you eat these.
No, you have to add up all the things. That should be the slogan. Grand Pappy Skippy's Demon Wings. You will actually go to hell.
Yeah, that's right. Commercials are just a quick zoom on my very serious face. You will literally go to hell if you eat these.
There is no God.
There is no coming back from this once you eat these.
I mean, all of the gods in Dark Souls are dead anyway, so...
It's true, God is dead. Wow, it's like this was written by a high schooler.
Toss him in our Skippy brand anathema sauce, and they're sacrilegious.
Right. Oh, a small envoy banner. Hey, that's great. We just completed the twisted version of the High Wall of Lothric, and now I guess moving
yeah,
on.
By the way, we're in Firelink Shrine from Dark Souls 1 right now.
Oh, okay.
Is that true?
Yeah.
Neat.
Time and geography are convoluted.
Yeah, everything kind of got balled up, like Hidetaka Miyazaki's notebook for the story of this game.
And look at that, a giant ring of rocks. I wonder where this could lead us.
The Ring City, the Ring City, that's the name of the DLC.
Isn't that just a caldera?
What?